Go to File, New and select here part. Now we are going to learn pipe routing. So pipe routing all a kind of assembly. So we have to perform in assembly section. Cancel it. Now pipe dimensions most always in inches. So I'll going to choose IPS. Routing parts, just a normal parts with routing information. Routing part has a routing point which stored all the information inside the part. So click SolidWorks add-ins and here you will find SolidWorks routing. Click. Once you click routing, you will see few windows like electrical, piping, tubing, user defined. So we are going to learn piping route. So if you see design library, there is one option called routing. Just check. Inside you will find many things like piping. Double click piping and see. So let's start with flange. Randomly we are going to create a model for pipe routing. So just drag and drop. And here you have to choose the size of your flange. So I am going to choose 150 NPS 6 inch pipe flange. Say OK. Would you like to save the assembly now? Say yes. And save in your destination wherever. I am going to say pipe assembly. Save. Now you will see a route property window pop-ups. Now it has some informations like this is the sub-assembly. All the parts going to line in sub-assembly. Then pipe. Here you will see the size of pipe, 6 inch schedule 40, even though you can change. Use weld gap. This is universal phenomena which is changed according to the condition. Bend elbow. Once you bend the 3D line, it will convert into elbow. So always keep use this, always elbow. Elbow size, you will click here. You will select 45 degree, 90, 180, whatever you like, but we will keep 90 degree, 6 inch schedule 40. At the end, automatically create fillet. So just check mark so that you will see a fillet once you finish the feature. Say OK. Now look. Now click change unit if inches. Now right click on the line and here you will see edit route. Even though in sub assembly here if you drop down you will see component and pipe. Pipe will be stored in route parts and components like elbow and flanges will be stored in components. So right click and edit route. Just drag. Now here you will see line option. Even in sketch also the same line option. So in piping I'll choose the line. Once you select the line you will enter in 3D sketch environment. See XY plane. So I'm going to click this. You will see XY direction. Let's drag here, here and press tab key to change the plane. If you see blue dash line means our sketch lies on the plane, on the line. Click here. Again I am going to put tab key on keyboard and change the direction. Skip. Now let's define the sketch. So that it is for us 50, 36, 65, let's say 100, let's say 100, okay. Now, if I want to add some more thing here, let's say I am going to delete this elbow. Let's add line. Out. Now go to piping and here you will find T section, T's. straight these inches, drag and keep this point, and you will see it took the shape leaf. 6 inch for the schedule, say okay. Now look, if you want to add here, just press tab key and put here. Now cancel. Now just hold shift key, this point and this point merge. See, it is automatically convert into arc. If you want to define the dimensions for this, even though you can define, let's say 35, okay. Now let's add some more thing here. We have here valves. Now gate valve, just drag and see it is aligned with the geometry, so press tab key, okay. Do you want to shorten the length of nipple? No. Now place something here. No. Cancel. Now click on this part and delete. Okay, just look. Now right click and edit routing, because once you refresh, you will out of this. Smart dimension, let's apply dimension for this. Let's say 30, that's fine. Now let's apply some more T here. See, okay, it's going upside. Now press tab key and change the direction. Cancel. Now let's apply some more dimension to this, from here to here, it's 30, and to this from here to here, 45, okay. Now let's apply spools. It is normally divide the geometry, so we have to apply flanges. Now drag and press here, say okay, select here, cancel. Now here applied. Now let's apply some more spools. Okay. Cancel. Now here applied, let's say what else geometry we need to apply. Let's apply here also. Say okay, just drag near top of the part. Okay, now similarly, and let's apply similarly to this part. Move your point. See, this is the center point. Say okay. Escape key to out. So here fixed. Now, so we also fix these spools also. Say. Now exit. Now, if you right click and define a spool. The first is blue color. First, this line, these are the spools. Spool 1, say okay. Spool 2, let's choose those lines which you want to make comes under what? Okay, these are the things which is going to be and this line. Okay, right click, define the spool, and the third spool is just beyond this line. Okay, now if you check here, you will find, see, spool 1, this is spool 1, this is spool 2, this is spool 3. Now simply exit and just click hide the line, and if you check, all the components these are all the components in routing. You will see 3D sketch, and in all the pipes are in route parts. So this is the simple tutorial. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.